I'm Matt.
And I'm Brittany.
We're here in Houston, Texas,
at the Downtown Aquarium. Today on Explorer's Corner, we're going to learn what it takes to care for a white tiger.
These tigers are so beautiful. And it's clear now that it takes much more than just feeding the tigers to keep them safe and healthy.
Hi guys, this is Nero, one of our oldest kitties. He's around 340 pounds. Let's do a little training with him, okay?
Okay.
Nero, target. Good. See, because he did it right, I'm gonna give him a little piece of meat. Nero, down. Good. So do you guys want to feed him on a meat stick?
Yeah, sure.
Cool. All right. We'll have you do it first. Stick it on through. And for you, I'm going to do a little bit special. I want you to stick it way up there, okay?
Okay.
Ready?
Nero.
So Nero's still just a baby. His birthday is in November. That'll be his second birthday. So he still has a lot of growing to do. His father was actually 500 pounds since he's only 340. He still has a few more pounds to put on him. We can stick it on through, give him a nice little piece.
He really likes this.
Yes, he loves his meat. All the training we do here is by positive reinforcement. And that means we give him something for doing what we ask. And with him, we use his meat. This is actually part of his diet. So we just cut up the meat and weigh it out in the morning, have it in a nice little container with his name on it, and give it to him throughout the day.
He's like a king.
Yes.
He gets everything he wants.
He does get everything he wants. He really enjoys working with people, and he loves doing anything for his food.
I can only imagine why.
So he's our oldest cat here at the Downtown Aquarium Houston.
Is there a real reason why he's white?
The white coloring of these Bengal tigers are due to a recessive gene. It's actually so rare that it's called leucic. Other leucic animals that you guys might know are the white alligator. It's just a really rare recessive gene. They say in the wild it's about 1 in 15,000 animals. But you don't see them very often in the wild because they are not very well camouflaged for that jungle.
What's the difference between a white tiger and, let's say, those orange tigers you usually see in the books?
In the books, they're the same thing. They just have a different hair color. There's actually 5 species of tigers left on the earth today. And this is the Bengal species. The Bengals also come in the orange variety with the black stripes.
Why do you train the tigers at all?
Oh, we train here at the Downtown Aquarium for husbandry behaviors. That's where we ask them to do things to help with their medical care. So, like, to get an injection. You guys go to the doctor and you get little injections during the year, right? They have an annual exam. They've got some shots that they need to get once a year, and we've trained them to come up to the side of the fence and take those shots in their hips voluntarily so they don't have to be anesthetized for that procedure. We also train them to stick their paws out underneath so we can check all their claws, make sure everything's okay. And we also train them for blood draw through their tails. Pull their tails out, there's a nice vein back there that we can draw blood without them having to be under anesthesia.
Do the tigers have any natural enemies?
Natural enemies would be us as humans. That is one of their biggest enemies. And our growth into their habitat is what's dwindling their numbers right now out in the wild. We need their habitat for more farmland, so they don't have much of anywhere to go except for onto the farmer's land. And of course, when that happens, the farmers decide to kill them and sell them for their body parts so they don't end up eating their cows. So we've got to help conserve their habitat so we can have these beautiful animals out in the wild all the time.
Do you breed the tigers at the zoo?
Here, we do not breed the tigers. And so here we'll just be housing them, showing them to the public so we can talk to the public about how we need to conserve and help these beautiful animals and their wild cousins.
About how many years old would the white tiger or Bengal tiger live to be?
In captivity, a tiger can live to be 20 to 25 years old. In the wild, they say if you make it up to adult age, they usually live to 15. Well, if you guys ever want to talk to a tiger, I'll teach you right now. It's really easy. You just put your lips together and blow really hard. It's kind of like blowing an imaginary raspberry. So let's try. Nero. Good boy. Good job.